Okay, I'm going to tell you guys a story about my baby bird. Someone brought me this birdie that was wobbling around in the yard, and they brought it in the house to me to take care of and said that, you know, something was wrong with it, whatever. And there was nothing wrong with it, but I didn't know that till later. I just took it in and took care of it and fed it worms. I went to the bird shop. I did everything I could. I got a shoebox and I put it in the window. I took it out on the deck to give it little baths in my pie pan. And I fell in love with this bird, you know. We would have just left it in the yard, though. The mommy bird would have came back for it. All it did was fall out of the nest and wobble away. I took him in. I thought something was wrong at first. But once he was in the house and I started feeding him and kept him in warm under lights over at night and kept him covered, though, so the light wouldn't be too bright. And I took him from room to room with me during the day to keep an eye on him. I was just connected to the hip with this baby birdie, and I called him Baby Birdie. And 2 weeks went by, and he'd fly around the house. He'd get on my lamp, and when I would take him outside to swim around and stuff like that in the little pie pan, everything, he just didn't want to fly away. He just kept hanging around. But at night, he would peck at the door and wanted to come in. So I let him in, and he was still getting all his feathers, so he just wasn't quite ready. And then I put him in the window where he would move his, tap his little foot, whatever, when I was playing music. And ironically, the song was about higher ground and stuff like that, so I didn't ever realize these things till later. You see the irony about things, but I would sing to him, and he just followed me around the house. I kept trying to get him to go outside, and one day, when he was sitting there on the little window ledge, facing out the kitchen window there, tapping his foot to the music, he turned around and went to fly out the sliding glass door there, but I had the screen pulled, and he didn't see the screen. He just seen the outdoors and smelled the outdoors, and he felt that he was ready. He just went to take off flying, and he hit the screen, and he fell back and snapped his neck and fell to the floor, and I scooped him up, and his neck broke, and he died in my hands. And it was so sad, you guys. I love this birdie so much. And, you know, I would call Baby Birdie, and he would just come flying whatever room he was in, or, you know, he was outside. I kept trying to get him to stay outside, but he just didn't want to be outside. And the day he decided to go outside and fly like a free bird was the day I had the screen door shut, and it was really sad. All right, you guys, I just had to share that story because I keep seeing these pictures popping up on my computer when I go to edit my videos. And I thought, you know, I'm just going to do that story, put that on video, and then put those pictures away in a different file. All right, everybody, thank you for watching. Arrivederci, everybody.
Strong, but life can be furious and things can go wrong. You go, we're better off tomorrow, but who knows if we get joy or sorrow. Stay true to that fire in your heart and your soul. Don't drench your desire in what you can't control. We fly, try so hard together, and we might be lost, but not forever.